Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.4, Problem 1. This is Section 7.4, Problem Number 1. It says, consider a normally distributed random variable with a mean mu equal to 43 and a standard deviation sigma equal to 2. Find the following probabilities. And the first one says, find the probability that x is greater than or equal to 45. So if you see visually what's going on, what we have is a normal probability. The mean will be the middle value, 43. 45 is a little bit bigger. Let's put it out here. And you want the probability that it's bigger. That's what we're looking for. Now, the problem is we can't just look up 45 in the standard normal chart. We don't have a 45 in it. We have to find the z value or z score for 45. So we're going to use the formula. Z equals x minus the mean over the standard deviation. So the x is the number we want to look up, which for this is 45. Minus the mean, which the problem tells us is 43, over the standard deviation, which the problem tells us is 2. So now if you do the math, in the numerator, 45 minus 43 is 2. In the denominator, you have 2. 2 over 2 equals 1. So what we have to look up is a z value of 1 and find that in the chart. So to look up 1, we want to start by writing the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. So that 1 gets written as 1.00. And then you want to split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So you're going to split it into 1.0 and then just 0. And then the next step after that is to put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. And then the last step is go to the 1.0 row of the chart, positive 1.0, the 0.0 column, which is the first column, and see where they intersect. And they will intersect at 0.8413. Now, the chart is set up to tell you the probability of being less than the value you look up, or to the left of it. So the 8413 is not the part we want. We want the part that's greater than, because the question asks greater. So I have to do 1 minus the chart value. So 1 minus 0.8413 would be 0.1587. That's the answer to part A. For this distribution with a mean of 43 and a standard deviation of 2, the probability of getting a result that's greater than or equal to 45 is slightly less than a 16% probability. Now, B, what's the probability that x is less than or equal to 44? So, again, let's take a look at what we're trying to find. We have a normal probability distribution. So the mean is 43, so that's going to be the middle value. 44 is bigger, so it's going to be a little bit after the mean, 44. And this time we want the probability that it's less than. So very similar process. I can't just look up the 44. I have to convert it into a chart value or find the z-score for it is the right way to say it. And then I can look it up. So it's going to be the same formula as before, x minus the mean over the standard deviation. So for part B, z equals x is, for part B, 44 minus the mean, which is 43, over the standard deviation, which is 2. So now in the numerator, 44 minus 43 is positive 1. In the denominator, 2. So I have a z-score of 1/2, which I can write as a decimal, 0.5. So I have to look up 0.5, positive 0.5. So same process as before. Write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. So 0.5 would be written as 0.50. Now it has two places after the decimal. Next, split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So it's 0.5. and 0. After that, you put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So instead of 0, it's 0.00. So now you go to the positive portion of the chart, find the 0.5 row, look until you intersect with the point 0, 0 column, which is the very first column, and they will intersect at a value of 0.6915. That's the value out of the chart. Now this time, because the question said less than, and the chart is set up to show you less than, the 6915 is exactly the part that I'm looking for. So the answer is just 0.6915. Again, notice part A, we had to do 1 minus the chart value because it was a greater than question. Part B, we got to take the chart value just the way it was because it was a less than question. So now, part C, what's the probability that X equals 41? So again, for this type of normally distributed problem, equal to, it's just automatically 0. I don't have to do any work, which is good. And now the last one, part D, what's the probability that 38 is less than or equal to X is less than or equal to 39? In other words, what's the probability that X is between 38 and 39? So you don't have to see the picture of what it looks like, but for a lot of people it helps. So you have a standard normal curve, or normal curve I should say. The middle value is 43 because that's the mean. So 38 and 39 are a little less, so they're going to be to the left of it. 38, 39, and you're going to have a little bit of an area. So I expect my area to be most likely a single-digit percent because it's narrow. I might be a little bit off. So what I have to do is convert both the 38 and 39 into a z-score, look up those two chart values, and subtract them. All in between, so you do a subtraction. So doesn't matter which one we do first. Go to the same z-score formula. We'll do the 38 first, no special reason. Z equals X. The X will be 38. Minus the mean. The mean is 43. Over standard deviation. Standard deviation is 2. So now 38 minus 43. Pay attention to the sign. That's negative 5. Very common mistake to miss the sign. 2 in the denominator, minus 5 over 2, you can write it as negative 2.5. So now we can go to the chart, look up negative 2.5. So to do that, write negative 2.5 so that it has two places after the decimal. So I'll write it as negative 2.50. Next, you take that number, split it into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So it'll be negative 2.5 and just 0. Then the rightmost digit that you took off, you put a 0.0 in front of it. So instead of 0, you write it as 0.00. Now you will find the negative 2.5 row of the chart, which is up close to the pause, the top of the negative part of the chart. The 0, 0 column is the very first column, and you'll see that it is 0.0062. So that's one chart value. So the 38 is giving me a chart value of 0.0062. I'll just write it down and keep it handy. Now I have to do the same process for the 39. Find the z-score for 39, look it up in the chart. Same formula. So z equals x. X now is 39 for this time. Minus the mean. The mean is 43. Divided by standard deviation, which is 2. So now do the math for that. On top, 39 minus 43 is negative 4. Don't lose the negative. And 2 underneath. Negative 4 over 2, you can reduce to just 2. 4 over 2 is 2. Make sure you remember it's negative. Now you're going to go to the chart, you want to look up 2. So first part of the process, write the 2 so that it has two places after the decimal. Let's write it as negative 2.00. Don't forget the negative, it'll make a big difference. Now take the number and split it into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So that last 0, you'll have a negative 2.0 and a 0. Now what you want to do is put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. And now you're going to go to the negative 2.0 row and intersect it with the 0, 0 column, and they will intersect at point 0, 2, 2, 8. So now I have two chart values, and what I have to do for an in-between is subtract the two chart values. You must subtract in an order that gives you a positive result, because your result is a probability. Probabilities can't be negative. So, let's put it right in here. I'm going to do the larger value, 0.0228, minus the smaller value, 0.0062. That'll give me a 6. It's a 16 with a 0 in front. So the final answer is 0.0166. So it's slightly more than a 1.5% probability that your value of x will be between 38 and 39.